In the 120 billion shillings lawsuit, the Commercial Courts Justice Henry Peter Adonyo ruled in the favor of city businessman Hamis Chigundu when it stated that the Act of DTB Kenya, which is licensed to carry out financial business in Kenya offering credit facilities in Uganda, was illegal. However, today the Supreme Court overturned this ruling.
Applicant seeks to use an application for judgment to stop the judgment that was supposed to be delivered today.
The panel of five justices of the Supreme Court, led by the Chief Justice Alphonse Owindolo, noted that the 120 billion shillings loan that Diamond Trust Bank extended to Ham Chigundu was legal. The justices explained that although DTB Kenya is not licensed to carry out financial institution business in Uganda and therefore could not appoint DTB Uganda as its banking agent within the provisions of the Financial Institutions Act 2004 and the Agent Banking Regulations of 2017, but rather work under a syndicated agents relationship.
The syndicated credit facility executed between the second respondent and the first appellant, with the first respondent as agent of the second respondent, is lawful, and neither the Financial Institutions Act of 2004 as amended, nor the Financial Institutions Agent Banking Regulations apply to them. Since the other members of the quorum are in full agreement with the judgment and orders, I have proposed the above judgment and orders accordingly hereby given in the terms stated out herein, dated this day of June 2023.
The justices referred the case back to the High Court for trial before another judge.
The issue of illegality having been resolved in this appeal, High Court Civil Suit number 43 of 2020, between the parties hereto, which was the genesis of this appeal, which was the genesis of the appeal, the Court of Appeal, and ultimately this court, is remitted back to the High Court for trial before another judge, basing only on issues of fact arising from the pleadings. The respondents are awarded 50% of the costs in this court.
The case originated from a syndicated banking agreement between Ham Enterprises Limited and the Kicks International Limited and the two banks. In another court trial of the seven people charged with AIGP Andrew Felix Kawesi's murder has stalled following the disappearance of one of the suspects identified as Jibril Kalyango. Kalyango was last year granted bail, however, he has since fled the country and efforts to trace him are still futile after numerous arrest warrants were issued against him. This has frustrated the rest of the accused persons, with some accusing the state of deliberately delaying the case.
Where is Mr. Kalyango?
Kalyango Jibril?
Joshua Chambade today asked that the state should stop the unnecessary adjournments and proceed with the hearing of the matter.
The time I spend in prison, the time is really growing. I'm a youth, so I need to plan. State, get it to be the last place.
No, you're not supposed to do that. You have told me I'm going to do that. So it's not that power.
Justice Alice Komhanji ordered prosecution led by Marion Benbela to tender in their application seeking permission to proceed by the 27th of June 2023. Eight suspects were arrested and charged with murder, aggravated robbery, terrorism, aiding and abetting terrorism, and belonging to a terrorist organization. They are Abdurashid Mbazira, Hamza Higenyi, Shafiq Kasuja, Yusuf Mugerwa, Bruhan Baliejusa, Joshua Chambade, Jibril Kalyango, and Yusuf Nyanzi.